What's up? What's up? What's up? What's up? I'm just having a little personal session, man. I'm just thinking about my Uncle Pete, man. In a little zone, man. I just wanted to share. I feel like talking tonight, man. You listening to me? Show me some love. You want to come in and kick it with me? Come in and kick it with me. I'm just vibing a little bit. That's all I'm doing. Just vibing. I'm gonna talk about being a spiritual farmer. Something I realized my Uncle P taught me in a way, and how it worked and what it means to be a spiritual farmer. You know what I mean? And if you're a spiritual farmer, then it's about planting seeds. And it's about gaining a harvest. You know, the fruit is always, you know, the fruit or the food or whatever it is you're planting. You know, you're always planting it for something. So I'm going to just wait a little bit for some people to come in. If you up in here, show me some love, man. What's going on, Keith? Hey, man, I got to get with you, Keith, man. I'm going to have to message you, man. I need you to do some simple artwork for me too, man. But yeah, if you in here, show me some love, man, so I can know who I'm talking to, man. I got a message about being a spiritual farmer and how it worked, man, and how we need each other, man, and how we all got to be farmers to kind of plant those seeds that give us that crop, that harvest, that keep us going in life, man, you know. Give it a little bit more time, man. Anytime I get deep in myself, man, it's one thing I love, man. When I have my own little zones, man, I love to get on my pipe, man, and just puff it, you know, just represent that wisdom, man. Like the Inspector Gadget type of thing, man. I inhale and exhale wisdom, man. Understanding, man, of how to love and how to be loved in a sense, you know what I mean? It's one thing to know how to love, but it's a whole nother thing to understand how to be loved. You know what I mean? How to be loved. That's a powerful thing, man. Are you lovable? You know, we can always say, man, well, I give this, I give that. But receiving is a big part of giving. And sometimes, man, we got to look at ourselves enough to say, are we receptive, or are we in position to where we can receive love from those who truly got to give it to us? So, you know, that's what it's about, man. But I'm going to go ahead and start. I was talking to one of my friends today, man. This guy, man, I met him about 14 years ago. And I met him at a job. And he old enough, he the same age as my mama. And me and him became good friends. We got the same birthday, see a lot of ourselves in each other, man. So for the last 14 years, man, you know, we done talked each other through some powerful things and powerful times in our life, man. And a lot of times when I be going through something, and I don't mean just, you know, nothing crazy, anything like that. I could just be going through something emotional that I want to understand. And I call this man, and he get on my ass. If I'm wrong, he get on my ass, you know what I mean? And we talk it out and work it out. Well, today, he was in a situation. And so we talked about it over a week or so, man. And he told me, he said, bro, you told me something the other day that changed my life. And I'm like, what you mean? He said, man, that shit was so powerful. And I'm telling him, I'm like, but the hell, what I told you is what you taught me, right? You know what I mean? He's like, what the hell you mean? I say, that's the same thing you gave me when I was going through something, I just returned it. So I started to think about what a spiritual farmer is. You know what I mean? And when you farming, you find good soil. You know what I mean? And you plant seeds in there, hopefully to bear a fruit. That fruit would be something that goes into your survival, your essence. You know, you plant food to survive. You plant things to harvest, right? So when we find sincere souls of each other, brothers, friends, family members, when you can truly be sincere with each other and vulnerable to each other and communicate in love, man, that's like soul-to-soul connections. So that soul becomes like the soil, right? And when I'm talking to my brother from the soul, everything I give him, man, comes from a beautiful place with powerful intentions, right? So when I plant those seeds into my brother and he take them in because he know I'm giving them out of love, and he start to ferment on those type of seeds, and they start to manifest and grow in his life, and he start to see the fruit of those seeds. You know, eventually when we come back around in our cycle, and it could be a time where, like you say, man, I need words of encouragement. The fruit of the very same seeds that I planted have grown into a tree, man, and bearing me a harvest of having friends and people around me that nourish me. You see what I'm saying, man? And gives me life. And I'm like, that's powerful, man. So every time we talk soul to soul with each other, every time you have a friend that knows where you're coming from and can uplift you, the things we say to each other, we are literally planting seeds in each other, man. Seeds of belief. Seeds of knowing you got somebody to care about you. And when those seeds grow up, man, and start bearing fruit, bro, in your darkest moment, it's those fruit from those trees that'll come give you the nourishment and the light to make you strong and keep on moving on, man. You know, I just thought that was a powerful thing. So when I say I'm a spiritual farmer, you know, that means everybody that I come in contact with and connect to on a soul-to-soul level, it's innately in me to drop seeds in their soul, man, that's going to grow into some beautiful power and fruit in their life. And when you get so much fruit on a tree, it got to fall off and roll down somewhere for somebody to be able to eat off of it. You know what I mean? So, you know, that's that, man. I just wanted to share that story. But I stay on here, though. Like I say, my uncle just passed, man. And I'm going to tell you something. It's like I was trying to find, you know, I had them pause moments. And I told myself, I say, man, why you ain't really sad? It's like I wanted to feel sad because my uncle died. And I had to be real with myself. And it was like, I can't be sad. And I don't know if the time will come or whatever. So I started to just think about it, man. And I said, you hear things like, you know, give people their roses while they living. And I can say, me and my uncle, we gave each other flowers every time we talked. You know what I mean, man? Uncle, I love you to death, man. Nephew, I love you to death. Uncle, I believe in you. Nephew, I believe in you. Every time I talk to that man, I feel like he added value to my day and vice versa, right? So he battled cancer. And down the stretch, one of the most powerful things he told me about when we talked was I never let the conversation to go into weakness about what he was going through. You know, one time I gave him the analogy. I said, hey, Unc, if you was in a fight and somebody hit you in your mouth and you looked at your hand and your mouth was bleeding, I say some people might say, oh, he hurt. Stop the fight. I say, but if you're a real man and you're a real warrior, you're going to look at that blood and you're going to assure those that are looking around and say, no, I'm all right. I'm still getting ready to fight. I still can fight. So I told him, I say, Unc, every time I talk to you, we laughing like hell. We talking like hell. I say, when people say, how your uncle doing? All I can say is, he all right. Shit, he fighting this fight. You know what I mean? He ain't down. So in that spirit, we talked in that way. You a warrior, Unc. You know, ain't nobody above the bullshit, Unc. You dealing with your bullshit, and I think you dealing with it the best it can be dealt with. Fight on, Unc. And he started going through the changes. And like you said, he went to the hospital last week. And so Sunday morning, I got off work at 7 o'clock. And I was at the hospital at like 7:20. You know, visitations had just started. So I'm up in there, man, and he looked at me like this. But he couldn't say nothing. And he was trying his best. And it was just like, you know, one time I did a video about how I can talk to the soul and talk through the soul. That soul to soul. When I saw he made the effort to put his eyes on me, you know, it wasn't no word that could have been deeper than what I felt, you know what I mean, about what my uncle was telling me. And all I told him was, fight your fight, Unc. So I came home and went to sleep. And when I woke up, they told me it passed. And it was like I knew in my soul, man, I felt like I walked with my uncle to the doors of freedom, in a sense, to the doors of God darn glory, the upper room. I walked him to the doors, man. And he told me, I love you, nephew. I say, I love you too, Unc. Fly high. I'll see you again if that's where it worked. You know what I mean? So here he gone, man. I can't be sad, man, because I gave that man his flowers while he was living. You know what I'm talking about, man? I gave that man his flowers while he was living, man. And that man was a real friend to me. That man was a real soul to soul with me, man. Soil. All we ever did was plant seeds in each other that grew up to be trees and bear beautiful fruit. And every fruit that he ever gave me and planted in me, I was real enough to take it back and let him eat off of it, man, and let it nourish his body, man. And that's what we is to each other, man. We all farmers, and we all fruit bearers of each other, man. So, you know, when you talk soul to soul, and when I say soul to soul, man, I'm talking about, man, sincerity, man. Even if you married, it's one thing to be a husband or a wife, but the foundation of a marriage in any relationship is friendship. And like I told you, being a friend simply means, man, I can be unapologetically me and bear my soul to you in a sincere way, to know that everything in you is to cultivate it and help it. That's what friendship is. And so when you are a friend first, man, before you are a husband, before you are a wife, before you are a nephew, a niece, a sister, a brother, man, you got to understand how to be a friend. And on top of that foundation, man, that's when you get to soul, and that's when you become a spiritual farmer. So, you know, my Uncle Perry taught me how to be a friend, man. So I'm a friend of many friends. But everybody who I consider a friend and who consider me a friend, like I say, I plant some heavy seeds in their soul. And sometimes I plant seeds in people's soul that they don't even know I done planted in their soul, man. That's why I call it spiritual, because what spirit means breath, you know, right? It means to blow breath. Because when you born into this world, out your mama, the first thing you do as an independent living being in this here world, the first thing you do is inhale. You take in the breath. You take in the spirit. And then you give it back. And you're going to do that 1-2 punch all the way to the end of the movie. The movie ends when you can't take one in and you can't take one back, can't give one back. So it's about breathing, right? And it's two parts to breathing. You got inhale, exhale. That's two parts. It's two parts to spirit. It's always two parts to everything. Everything has a polarity, positive and negative. So when you get into the spiritual aspect of breathing, when I inhale, you see what I'm saying? I ingest. It's what influenced me. When I exhale, it's what I express, what I expire. You see what I'm saying? So when you talk about being a spiritual farmer, it means that I know if you in a room with me, or if you even know me, period, I know my spiritual power in enough to say that if you inhale this shit out my hill mouth, if you inhale or ingest or get inspired by this here shit that come out of my mouth, then I already know what it's going to do to your expression. You see what I'm saying? So I know how to plant a seed. You know what I mean? And that's what friendship is about. You know, that's what it's all about. So that's the spiritual part. And we all are spiritual. You all inhale and we all exhale in a sense to where, you know, you got to understand which part of it are you. Are you more of an inspirer, or are you more of a, you know, they say a leader or a follower? And it's not about being leading or following so much, because I inhale everything that I know is sincere and love. That's why I call it being soul to soul. And sometimes I know sincere fools. I know some sincere fools. But I value that and I learn from that because I know it's sincere. You see what I'm saying? And they teach me how not to be foolish. And I plant seeds in them on how to mature and how to grow beyond foolishness. But both of us is necessary for each other. You see what I'm saying? That's the essence of friendship. That's the essence of family. That's the essence of us, man. When I say we all we got, we all we need. That's the spirit of breath, man. You know what I mean? And going back to the tree analogy, that's why I say, even when you look at nature, and I ain't trying to get too deep, and I'm going to bring it back in, but even when you look at nature, somebody asked me one time, they say, how do we breathe? I say, your lungs. He say, what do we breathe? I say, oxygen, right? And he said, who make oxygen? I say, trees make oxygen. That's we need trees to breathe, right? And if you look at any picture, our lungs look like trees, right? The nature will show you this, right? So trees give out oxygen, which is what we need to breathe. Our breathing system is called your respiratory system. So it's all about your respiratory system. See how that's broke down in words? Your respiratory system. And we need trees to breathe, because trees give out oxygen, which is an invisible gas that's necessary for existence. So when I say I am a spiritual farmer, just as much as I am a product of a seed, see, I am a tree, and my inspiration and my aspiration that goes away from me, that's my influence. That's my oxygen. It's the very same thing that I and everybody else like me needs to survive and breathe. Do you see what we are to each other? I am simply a tree, and I bear fruit, figuratively and literally. I got children. I bear fruit. I bear motivation, inspiration in the hearts of my brothers, in the hearts of my friends, to inspire them to believe in themselves. Those are my fruit. We all are fruit. We all have seeds. You understand? And this ain't complicated. It's simple. But see, here's where it get, man. A lot of times, we apply negative connotations to every situation. Now, we can tell our children every day, and we can get on our children and say, you hang around the wrong crowd. They gonna get you in trouble. They gonna do this, and they gonna do that. You better stop hanging around her. She ain't shit. You better stop hanging around him. He ain't shit. And all we telling our children is, don't you let people plant bad seeds in you. They're going to inspire you to be crazy. They're going to inspire you to hurt yourself. We're constantly telling our children and each other, hey, don't you let them put them bad seeds. But we don't understand the power and what it creates to take power. We see the negative, but there's always a positive side. So just as much as that boy can come in your child life and make your child have bad grades, make your child skip school, that somebody can come in your life and get your child on drugs and get you on drugs and make you lose it all and make you do everything. We always see that story. Somebody can see that woman and go start talking to that woman, and next thing you know, he got that woman cheating on her husband. We always see the power of spirit and planting seeds when it comes to negativity. But see, we got the same power and spiritual power in positive. And I believe in that. And I live that. And you can live that too. The very same way you can have a child that befriends your child in school. And your child been struggling in school for a long time. But it's one friend that can ignite your child in a prideful sense to say, now his grades being good. I believe that I can meet a man who don't understand the value of family, the value of a wife, the value of cultivating your children. And I'm not saying my intentions are to save him, but my intentions are as Cousin Dion, as a fruit bearer. I got to give it. I got to plant it. I ain't nothing but a farmer. So if I plant my seeds in him, then I got to be confident that not only am I telling him, I'm showing him how a strong black man fights temptation to resist the things he desires, to protect the ones he loves. I'm showing him with intentions of trying to be the best father I can be, trying to be the best husband I can be, trying to be the best friend I can be. I'm showing him enough to say that I just believe that my seed, my spirit, I'm going to inspire him to just make him think about going through the door of change, man. We can do that for each other. We can do that for each other, man. That's why I say we spiritual farmers. I ain't nothing but an old farmer. And every time I connect to a person that look like me and love like me, every time I connect to their soul, man, see, that soul becomes soil. And I plant it, baby. And I've planted some mighty, mighty trees in life, man, that done bear some fruit to me, man, that I can't even explain to you how juicy it was and nourishing it was. Oh, God, it was so good to me. You know what I mean, man? I love you, man. Hey, Dion. What's up, Cousin Pravis? What's up, Lisa? What's up, Shay? What up, Chandler? What up, Fripp? If you're still watching, I'm just showing some love, man. You know, I'm just vibing out, man. Like I say, in the spirit, man. Just talking about my uncle, man. There's a noun and a verb to everything. There's a noun and a verb to everything. I'm a father in the sense of the noun. But in the verb, it's the actions of being a father. How do I father? What is it to be a father? Not just in the noun sense, but in the verb, right? I'm a parent. But do we understand what it means when we parenting? You understand what I'm saying, man? See, a lot of times we romanticize the ideas of being, but we have no reality. No, I take that back. We romanticize the ideas of becoming something, but we don't have no reality of being. You see what I'm saying? And see, the being starts in the intentions. See, nobody is above the bullshit. Nobody got it all figured out. We all in the game, playing for the same thing, to survive and to maintain. But it's the intentions, man, that creates the verbs of being. You understand? It's the intentions. So if I'm a father, my intentions, every day I wake up, man, is the break away, to make a way, with intentions of raising my children, man, to understand this here world in a way that when they leave their mama and daddy, they are equipped to survive and be rooted in this world enough, man, that just like they've been learning right now, ever since they've been little, the story of the three little pigs. I'm trying to raise them enough, man, to understand that when the big bad wolf come and huff and puff and blow, I want my baby's house to be made of brick and not hay and not wood. Because the big bad wolf can't blow no brick house down. So every day I wake up, those are my intentions. And even if I make bad decisions, even if I make mistakes, they rooted in pure intentions. So that gives me the comeback, the bounce back to get it right. You understand what I'm saying, man? So that's why I say it's about the verb, man. And when you look at all the nouns you are, if you're a mother, if you're a father, if you're a husband, if you're a wife, if you're a sister, if you're a brother, if you're a son, if you're a daughter, if you're an uncle, if you're an aunt, those all are nouns. And if you divinely got those positions, you can't trade them positions in. You can't decide to not be a son. You see this right here. This is the key of life. Father, mother, children. I don't care who you are. You are part of the cycle. Those who turn the key shall live forever. We all are a product of the turn. Everybody turned the key. That's why we here. If you got children, you turned the key. That's the cycle. That's the recycle. We all are rees of the cycle. So you can't turn off your position in this here thing. So if you are a mother, what's the verbs of being a mother? If you are a father, what's the verbs of being a father? If you are a brother, what's the verbs of being a brother? But like I told you, the foundation of every relationship is friendship. And a friend is somebody that you can sincerely talk to. And get soul to soul with. And plant your seeds. And bear fruit of those seeds that's been planted in you. That's the ultimate verb. And if you can just have intentions of every relationship, just those intentions, that's when they say you can let go and let God. And they say good people land in soft places, so don't never be scared to get in the wind. That's because my intentions have brought me to every moment I'm at. And if I ain't never had no bad intentions, then I got to be where I'm supposed to be. See how that work, man? You see how that work? I think it's simple. But, like I say, to everything, there's two sides. There's a positive, there's a negative. Both are necessary to make it work. But you got to understand, man. You got to understand your position in it, you know? I talked about, I don't know if y'all ever watched these videos. And this is what I'm saying, man. I don't go live a lot, but I always understand this. And if you listen to this, like I say, I ain't one that's not that's ashamed to say, I love Facebook, man. Nah. I love Facebook. I love this shit here, man. This shit give me an outlet to exercise my mind and my thoughts. But I want you to say, I want you to understand this here. In this here real life of here we live in. I don't give a damn how crazy you think I might be or how radical or whatever the hell you think I type on this here thing. If I say it and I put it on here, I'm talking about in real life. I bet your bottom dollar. I bet my life on it. I ain't bullshitting about it now. And I can show you better than I can tell you. Right? So, just like when I make a video about vampires, you say, well, he talking crazy. But no, this the shit that's in real life. Because if you watch a vampire movie, it's about the same thing I've been talking about up until this here live. It's the same thing. Spiritual farmers, inspiration, motivation, expression, experience, inspire. It's all about breathing. Inhale, exhale. When you go to the ABC store in Charlotte, North Carolina, they call it spirits. They say this is a spirits. That's what's on the sign. ABC spirits. Because when you go get every bottle out of there, when you ingest that and come under the influence of everything in that building, it changes your expression. That spirit. And they telling you right there, simple as in your face, this ain't nothing but an old spirit box. Come take this shit in and we'll take control of what comes out. See how that spirit? They call it spirit. If they call it spirit and you know they call it spirit, say something on the line to me. Show me that you're with me, y'all. Show me that you're with me, man. Right? So, in the very same way, man, when you hear me talk about vampires, every vampire movie, man, it's the same old shit. If you saw one vampire movie, you saw them all. Somebody gonna get bit. Hell, they don't like daylight. They don't like silver. It's gonna always be around a love story. Y'all know how vampire movies go. If you saw one, you saw them all. Vampires are those that people that done got bit and misery love company. So now they bit, they a vampire, and they intentions and they motive becomes to, I need to find somebody who's pure so I can bite their ass so they can be a vampire like me because this shit done took over my spirit and all I want to do now is infect other people to be like me. So I'm a spiritual farmer, AKA a vampire, same shit. Once you get it, you got it. See what I'm talking about? So in this here world, I can simulate some real life shit. Huh? You got a man and a wife, a husband and his wife. You see what I'm saying? Shit come at them. They ain't friends no more. They can't talk. They can't talk to each other no more. So now they ain't friends at the time. See how that work? They can't talk to each other. Cause they ain't friends no more. And when you ain't got a friend and you can't talk, man. See, I told you, friendship is about soul to soul. You see what I'm saying? And when you ain't got a friend, your soul becomes goddamn rugged and rough, and it ain't fertile for good seeds no more. Huh? So when you ain't got your friend, right, you become weary, right? And he go to work and she go to work. And you got old vampire at work. Huh? Got your old vampire at work. Oh, yeah. Yeah, old vampire got charisma. You see what I'm saying? And all he looking for is somebody who pure and vulnerable so he can bite her ass, turn her into an old vampire, right? And so he go and he, like say, every vampire movie, he started talking to her. And he realized because her and her husband ain't friends no more. You see what I'm saying? They ain't talking. They fucked up right now. So what seeds she do got in her? Ain't nobody watering the seeds. Ain't nobody, her husband, she done come to work this morning, and her husband ain't told her, good morning, baby. Her husband ain't told her, I love you, baby. Her husband ain't told her, hey, baby, I like your hair, baby. Her husband ain't told her, good God almighty, baby, you smell good. Her husband ain't even rubbed her and made her feel like a woman, cause they ain't friends no more, right? So this old vampire sees that. And now this old vampire say, hey, good morning. Look at you. I see that hair look good. I see you. And because her soil, her soul, ain't been watered the right way, in the right order, that drop of water say, ah, and when she draw up like this right here, right, that vampire get on in that neck. Ah. God damn it, she bit. God damn it, she bit. Huh? And now she got the reason with the venom of a vampire. So that's what a vampire is. Somebody that could plant seeds of destruction. Seeds of destruction and bear fruit out of it. And she fucking at work in the bathroom on break. God damn. And I done saw it in real life. A vampire and his motherfucking victim, right? But on the flip side, I talk to my brothers. I'm a vampire slayer. I beat a motherfucking vampire ass. And when I see a vampire in real life, oh, motherfucker, you in my movie now. And I ain't no goddamn vampire. I'm a vampire motherfucking killer, nigga. Right? So this is what our hero trained to tell my brothers. I say, if that's your woman, bro, and you love that woman, and cut the bullshit and be real about that woman, right? I say, so if that's your woman, and you've been together all these years, and if your intentions, remember I told you, it's about intentions. If your intentions is to love that woman, protect that woman, provide for that woman, give that woman security, then you get into the verbs of being a husband. You get into the verbs of being a man. You get into the verbs of being a father. So everything you do with your intentions is about planting those seeds in your woman. And if you playing this game with the right intentions, see, like I tell my wife, one of the most powerful things in this here world of mine to be is mine. And that's my wife. So when she mine, my intentions is to understand it so I can work it and make it work for me and with me. So that's mine. I get so deep in trying to understand how she work. that I work it so good with the best intentions that I could possibly have and all the effort in my life. So when she walk out that door here that we call home, man, hey man, hey look, she the main character in a motherfucking vampire killer movie, man. That's all I can say. You understand what I'm saying, man? And that's the power of it. If your intentions are right, as a father, as a husband, as a man, then you play this game, man, and you be a spiritual farmer to those in your own home, to those that you soul to soul with, your best friend, your wife, your children, to the point where when they do encounter the opposition, man, that shit can't grow no roots in there, man. Not when I till this thing up and tend to this here soil every day like a real farmer do. You see what I'm saying, man? Like a real farmer do. A real farmer tend to his crops. His crops are planted in powerful, fertile soil. The people that I call friends and love, and the verbs, man, of what I am to them, man, those are all my crops, man. Those are all the souls that I'm connected to, man. And I'm a farmer, man. I go above and beyond, man, to water, to prune, to cut all through the goddamn seasons, man, to the point where, man, hey, man, I know my harvest coming. See what I'm talking about? Hear that beat, man? They talking about check, man. Cut the check, man. That's mathematics, man. 2 + 2 = 4. Huh? 2 + 2 = 4, man. What's your math, man? Huh? What you trying to get? I told a brother, hey, man, meet me at the 7. On fatherhood. I say, meet me at the 7 on fatherhood. He say, all right, brother. Ain't nothing else got to be explained. Because he a mathematician on fatherhood. And if I say, meet me at the 7, I don't give a damn if he take 2 and 5, 4 and 3, 6 and 1. And he don't give a damn if I take 6 and 1, 2 and 5, 4 and 3. We know how to get to 7. We know the intentions. You know what I'm talking about? Huh? You know what I'm talking about? Write the goddamn check, man. Write the goddamn check, man. Write the goddamn check, man. You see what I'm talking about for real? Huh? I got a song called 100. I start off by saying, when a conversation don't equals 200, I'm moving on. And lately I've been having some goddamn 185s out this mug. Write the check, man. Write the check, and I know you can cash it. Because I know what I put the math in. I know the math in it. I'm a mathematician, man. Huh? You look at an equation. You look at an equation. I can look at, I can look at a situation and I see the equation. I see what it is. Man, me and my old lady going through this. We're going through that. Or man, my son this, my son that, this and that. And I say, you look at the equation. And then I get to talking. And they say, how you know that, man? I ain't even told you. How you know that? I say, brother, I ain't talking about you. I'm talking about me. We all in the shit doing the same thing. We all in the same math. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Those are the root of all damn numbers in the universe. No matter what you do in math, on any level, the foundation of all math is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So if you can count, come on, man. And math is its most powerful when it's simple. You most powerful at math when it's simple equation. What's 2 plus 2, 4? You can say that with confidence. What 2 plus 2, 4? What 5 plus 5, 10? See, you fire off when you're confident about your math. What 5 times 1, 5? But see, when them problems get complicated, down goes your confidence. Hold on. I ain't good. I you know, now you realize, goddamn, I done forgot how to do. You know, you see that shit on Facebook when they put them math problem. Motherfucker don't understand. Please excuse my dear Aunt Sally for shit. They get them shit wrong all goddamn day, cause now you done made the equation complicated. So when I talk about mathematics, man, I'm talking about your life. Stand back and look at the math on your life. There's power in simplicity. Yeah, I'm gonna pay my bills, and I make this and I make that and food and all the necessities of life. Yeah, I can make it. But now you wanna add goddamn weed. You wanna add some bullshit. You want to add, you want to start adding all this shit to the equation. And now you got to start goddamn multiplying, dividing, ratio. Fucking, yeah, hell. Now you done start throwing letters in there. 1 plus C equals 3 plus B times 10. And the equation becomes, what the hell is C and B? Cause now you on some crooked ass shit and you can't be real with all of your goddamn numbers. So now your equation done got so fucked up that you don't even know how to solve it. And then you come and say, man, I'm fucked up. So you goddamn right you fucked up. Your life on some calculus shit, nigga. So, life, I as a man, I look at life as being a woman, man. And a woman love a good old kiss, man. Keep it simple and sweet, man. And if your life is fucked up right now, and that ain't for nobody to determine. That ain't for nobody to determine if your life fucked up right now. That ain't for nobody to determine. That's for you in that damn mirror to know where you at with your intentions. Where you at with your intentions? If you got a man right now, where you at with your intentions? If you got a woman right now, where you at with your intentions? If you got children right now, where are you at for your intentions? What do you intend for your children? Huh? Some people ain't even got no intentions for their children. They say, I'm just going to feed the motherfuckers and give them somewhere to stay, goddamn. Hey, look. That's all I intend to do is keep the motherfuckers alive. You know what I mean? If that's your intentions, if that's all you intend to do with your children, at least intend to be a true goddamn friend to your child. If you can't give them nothing in life, give your child a friendship, man. That they can call, man, and get soul to soul with their parent, because that's the verb of parenting. See how that work again? That's the verb of parenting, man. That's the verb of parenting. And you to start your own movie so you can write your own lines and You know, but hey, like you say, what is your movie about? Once again, that's your intention. What is your movie about? That's the narrative, and that, you know, that's what your movie is about, man. But you know, hey, man, I'm just vibing, man. What's up, Tanya? Yo, man, what up, Eb? I love you, little sister. What up, brother? I love you, brother. If you want to come in and show me some love, I'm just vibing, man. If you want to come in and show me some love, or just show me some love. Well, if you want me to talk about something, ask me, man, what to talk about. I'm just rambling on. But if you want me to talk about something, if you got a question about anything, man, I'm going to get it to you raw, man, raw and real, man. But, you know, this another thing, too, man. I love when people ask me shit, you know. Just like, it's people see me every day where it is, and they never ask me what the hell this really means. And then I see them trying to get woke, and they got their own journey, but, motherfucker, if you ain't never asked me, then you ain't gonna never know what the fuck I think, cause I promise you, you probably ain't never heard it the way I'm gonna say it. But I say this. People say it's all about telling the truth, and which I don't agree. But going back to being a farmer, I'm also a chef, right? I'm also a chef, and I prepare truth. So there's a difference between cooking and preparing food. I can put it in the oven, and the oven will cook it. Cooking is the elements of heat and the process of heat in relation to food. That's cooking. Anybody can cook. You can put some shit on the top of the stove, and the motherfucker will cook itself. You just gotta take it off at some point of cooking. But the essence of serving food is in the preparation of the food. So I don't just cook, I prepare food as a chef, right? So as a preparer, I prepare my truth. I prepare the truth that I serve. And I'm so prideful in my truth that I serve in dish forms is that I would never tell you the truth without my soul in it, to the point where I want it to be fulfilling and great just as much as it is nourishing. Because a motherfucker can tell you, oh, I'm going to tell you the truth what it is, and they give it to you. That's like saying, I ain't seasoning this goddamn food. I don't give a damn what the fucking food tastes like. Eat the motherfucking food. Didn't you say you're hungry? So when I see somebody who claims the noun and the verb of being a truth server, motherfucker, shut the fuck up, man. Cause your food is nasty and ain't nobody want to eat that bullshit. So I said all that to say, if you ain't asked me a question about me, then you ain't never ate my motherfucking cooking. I can tell you that right goddamn now. And I don't give a fuck who tried to explain me. Can't no motherfucker cook my dishes like me, cause I don't share my sauces. You understand where I'm coming from? You understand where I'm coming from? You understand where I'm coming from? What he believe? Do he believe this? Do he believe that? Do he believe? Ask me, goddamn. Because after I tell you, goddamn, hey, that motherfucker gonna be dripping off your goddamn lips. Might say, goddamn, I don't believe that shit neither. Spiritual farmer, I plant a motherfucker seed in your ass. Do it every day. Do it every goddamn day. What he believe in? Ask me. I guarantee you it's gonna feel good when I tell you. Cook that motherfucker with love before I serve it to you. That one thing I say about my Uncle Perry. I call my Uncle Perry some nights I be on one. I say, Uncle P, I saw a goddamn alien today. And Uncle P know me so much and know me so real. When I say I saw an alien today, he say, oh hell. He say, tell me what it looked like. And he already know this motherfucker finna go somewhere real as hell. And when I get through, he gonna say, that motherfucker was a goddamn alien, wasn't it? I said, you damn right, Uncle Pete. You see that motherfucker? He said, I see him, man. That motherfucker alien. And if you ain't get that, then the hell with it. You know what I mean? Don't ask me a goddamn thing if you ain't get what I said right there. But yeah, Dion. Hey, Dion, we was over Perry House tonight, man. Old Pop and Steve and everybody, man. And one thing I say, man, I love getting around my cousins, man. I'm tell you, man, them some funny-ass people, man. When I tell you, laughter and, once again, friendship. When you can get with your cousins, man, and y'all can just let go. You know, that's one thing about me, man. Dude told me, he said, man, you funny as hell. And I was like, man, I ain't goddamn funny, man. I'm trying to be serious. But he kept on laughing. Man, you funny as hell. You funny as hell. But the reason I was funny is because I was around real love, man. And when you're around real love, man, you can let go and let God, man. And if you play this game for real, man, the essence of who you is, man, got to be in laughter and smile. You know what I mean, man? So when you're truly yourself and you can truly let go and let God, I hope in those moments you can't do nothing but smile like a motherfucker and laugh like hell, man. You know what I mean, man? That's real talk. Oh, yeah, Dion, it's going to be real, man. It's going to be real whenever we send Uncle P off, man. It's going to be a celebration. And if I got, and look, like I said, we talking about spiritual influence and expression. And if I got anything to do with it, and I'm going to prepare myself and work out to make my breath real strong and my wind real powerful, that when I blow, I'm going to blow all sadness away. And I want this thing to be a celebration, man. In the honor of glory. That's what I told my uncle. I say, Unc, you fight till you can't fight no more. And when you done, Unc, I'm going to write your story in glory. I say, I'm going to stand on a mountaintop, Unc, and I'm going to tell your story in glory. I say, and they going to know that my uncle was the greatest uncle that a man in this here world can have as a nephew. And I'm going to yell it out from the top of my lungs. And so when I say my spiritual power, my influence, when I blow it, I'm going to blow all sadness away in the thought of my uncle flying high. Don't y'all be sad about my uncle flying high. Because my uncle fought the fight in the way that the fight ain't never been fought before. And my uncle fought till he walked to the door. So you let my uncle go, goddamn it. And if you want to, like I said, he gave all of us enough memories and love that anytime you think about my uncle, you can't do nothing but smile if you know my uncle. And if you think of my uncle right now and you don't smile, man, or laugh about some shit he done told you and you done told him as a friend, then I know you ain't know my uncle, and I don't think you was his friend. Because if you were my uncle's friend, goddamn, every thought gonna make you smile. So how can you be sad right now? Only person I feel like can be sad is my uncle and his wife. And that's just because she losing her best friend. God almighty. I'm tell you what God love, man. God don't love nothing but the truth, man. And like I said, your ideas of God and mine most likely is different. But I tell you one thing. Hey, tell you what God love. God love the truth. And I don't care who God it is and which God it is. He love the truth. You know what I mean? I'm going to tell you that right there. What's up? What's up? What's up, Reggie? Big brother Reggie, I love you, man. I love you, man. Glad you're coming through, brother. I love you, man. Good to see you, man. Real talk, brother. Just on here talking about, man, being real friends, man. Being trees out here in this world. Bearing them fruit, man. Planting them seeds, man. Being old spiritual farmer out here, man. being old spiritual farmer out here, man. Everybody I connect with, soul to soul, man. That soil, they put seeds in me. I put seeds in them. Those seeds grow up to be a tree. And sometimes those, well, not sometimes, but all the time, those trees bear fruit that I can one day take a bite of and eat for my own nourishment. I started off talking about one of my friends, my big brother, man. He told me, he said, bro, you changed my motherfucking life the other night with our conversation. I say, all the thing I said to you was the shit you told to me when I was going through the same damn thing. I say, now, ain't that crazy? You come around and say you got your life changed by the same seed you planted in me. Good God Almighty, ain't nothing but old fruit of his. See how that work, man? Ain't nothing but old fruit. Ain't nothing but old fruit, man. That's all I am is old fruit. See what I'm talking about? I know my position. You know what I'm talking about? But I love it, though, man. I love y'all, man. I want to get off, but I don't even want to damn get off, man. I ain't sleepy. It's 11 o'clock. I swear I ain't sleeping. Hey, man, somebody, I'm going to get off in a minute before I get redundant. Somebody asked me something, man. Any damn thing, man. Give me something to talk about, man. You know, I ain't just no rambling nigga, you know. Like I say, I'm a chef, man. I can cook the order. But I guarantee you one damn thing, that motherfucker gonna be good. Hey, Eb, if you on here, say something, Eb. Real talk, Eb. If you still on here, say something, Eb. Because I want to say this. Like we say, the verb, right? My sister say she was on the way over here today. And I've been thinking all day. I say, man, I cooked some steak yesterday, right? So all night, it's crazy shit. You can say what you want to say about deep thought, but I say the next day, I'm gonna make some motherfucking steak and egg sandwiches. That's gonna be so goddamn good, man. Like I told you, I operate out of my imagination. So if I'm gonna make a steak and egg sandwich in my imagination, I'm working in Right Star Cafe. You know, that's one of my business ideas and dreams that's gonna come and manifest in due time. But I often go there and be there whenever I want. Damn the validation of it. They say the revolution begins in the mind. Everything begins in the mind. So in my mind, I am and always has been and always will be. So I told my sister, she said, I'm on the way. I said, well, do you want a steak and egg sandwich? She said, hell yeah. And I already know, I don't know where her imagination at with it. But when she came here, I told her, I say, it's about to be the goddamn sexiest motherfucking steak and egg sandwich you ever done seen. Because once again, those are my intentions. I'm about to cook this motherfucker up just like I see it in my imagination, right? And she said, God damn, this thing deep. She said the sandwich was deep. I said, good God almighty, right? But I said all that to say, man, ask me any goddamn thing, I'm gonna cook it where it tastes good. You know what I mean? Hey, look. See, I'm just talking bullshit. I'm just saying any damn thing. But yeah, I'm finna go, man. Unless y'all got a question, man. Got a question, you got something you wanna say, say that shit, man. Ask me some shit, man. Make me talk about some real shit. Make me talk about some funny shit. Make me talk about any goddamn thing. Because it's nights like this, in moments like this, that's real talk, that I would call my Uncle Perry and get on the phone and talk like hell right now. But my Uncle Perry gone, man. My Uncle Perry gone, so I'm just talking in his spirit. I know he listening to me. I know he listening to me right now. He up there telling him, yeah, man, you know me and Trav still talk, man, about every day. Yeah, I'm on that peat pipe. What's up, Cousin Nita? How you doing? I love you, Cousin Nita. Anybody want to come in and show some love? Anybody want to come in and show some love? Huh? I want to say this too, man. I'm going to get political, right? A lot of people say, man, what's your political stand? I'm going to tell you like I told you, man. If you know how it works, man, you can watch it. You can watch it being worked. I don't really give a damn about none of that political shit. When I say I don't give a damn about it, I understand how it worked. I understand how everything... Yeah. Love you too, cuz. I understand how it all worked. But I'm real enough to not put my emotions into the bullshit of how it worked. Like, it's all a game that's being played on our mind. Like you say, if you emotionally think that one side or either side really is about your motherfucking self, I don't know, man. You about crazy as hell a little bit. That's the way I look at it. But I ain't mad at nobody who just get all intertwined with it. I just think some people need avenues and outlets of mental shit, and they use that. So be it. But, you know, in real life, man, sacrifice leads to discipline. No matter how they change the rules. Just like if you at work, I'm pretty sure if you done been at a job for amount of years, there's been many procedure changes. There's been many management changes. There's been many order or operation changes. They've come in and everybody be like, man, they done did it right here. And everybody think the management is stupid as hell for changing it. But regardless of how they change it, there's still one objective. You going there to get a check to survive and to maintain. And whatever they doing there, their objective is to fulfill that objective, whether it be making, selling, moving, buying, shipping, you goddamn all that shit. So in real life, regardless of what the circumstances are, it's through our own discipline, sacrifice, and intentions that we gonna find our way through anything to be who we are and who we meant to be. And like I said, you've been you since your birthday. And when you realize who the hell you is, you can roll with any change. And unless you real enough to go to the tables of change, then don't you get emotionally wrapped up about some bullshit that you can't change. Just play the game, man, to win. You know what I mean? Just play the game to win. And that can be on many different levels, like you say, and it's certain people on different levels. Like, and some people say, well, how does that apply? Some things I don't like, and some things I won't change. But I've been in meetings with city council. I've been in meetings with the sheriff. I've been in meetings with some very powerful, influential people. And just like I told you, man, in the beginning of this here video, I ain't nothing but old spiritual farmer, man. And I put some seeds in they ass that I might not ever eat the fruit. But I know my seeds is some good ass damn seeds. You see what I'm saying? So when it comes to that political shit, man, stop giving your ignorant filled emotions to that type of thing and put your intentions where they're golden. All your nouns in the verbs of being. Do you understand what I'm saying? All your nouns in the verbs of being. And like I say, and just like I say, well, man, do you like Donald Trump? I don't give a damn about Donald Trump, but I'm going to tell you this right here. If you think, and just take this fundamental thing. I'm going to tell you like this. It's a person right now staying in Piper Glen in a big-ass house with a big-ass Benz. And he probably is the boss of your job. And you at work right now. And you probably look at that man and think, he is the smartest man in the whole damn world. Because look at his life. This man got money. This man can't be dumb. And I ain't saying you personally, but in general, that's the way people think. But if you think that Donald Trump, a damn billionaire, a man who's the head of many corporations that pay many millionaires and sustain many lives, if you think that motherfucker's stupid, then I pay you $20 to read a goddamn page of paper out loud in front of a crowd. Anybody who thinks Donald Trump's stupid, I'll pay you $20 to read a motherfucking paper out loud in front of a crowd. See how, you know what I mean? Don't even put your mind in that bullshit, man. Focus on what's real, man. Focus on being a friend to your spouse, to your loved ones, to everybody that matter. Stand in that mirror and work on your intentions, man. I love you.